think the biggest thing for me when I think about deeper learning is how can I have my students be truly engaged, have them want to learn, have them have fun with their learning, but also be really connected to rigorous academics and really hit the content that's most important. By having an engaging project or an engaging task, making things real world in a way that feels meaningful to them, all of those things lead to supporting all students with deeper learning. Students are working on a project-based unit where they are going to be designing their own mini golf course. So throughout that whole project, we are incorporating grade level content. We looked at different shapes and angles and lines that made up mini golf courses. Then we talked about ratios and proportions and how a normal size mini golf hole would look and how do we scale that down as we make our plans. We were talking about budgeting and area so that we can build by turf to actually create the holes. And so tying in a lot of different skills as we work on this big project.
So today we're going to be working on our mini golf projects. And we are going to be talking about finding the area of composite shapes. We are going to start with a warm-up. And in that warm-up, you're going to work with your small groups. Then we're going to do a whiteboard task. We're going to then do an exit ticket. And then we're going to apply what you practiced today. And you're going to work on your projects and finding the area of your mini golf holes. You are going to work on this activity in partners. And you are each going to get an envelope. Okay? In that envelope, you'll have several shapes, equations, and then areas. Your goal is to match the correct shape with the equation with the area. Questions about our warm-up? All
right. And then it would go as, let's try to mesh these up first. A equals half base.
Okay. So I like your formula here.
H.
Area times width. Where? What part of the shape do you think we're going to do length times width?
That's not half of it, though. Because if we want to divide this by two, it's got to be like half. It's not. It's like taking up like the corners. So we do like 7 times 4, and then we get 28. So, and then like try to find an equation for that. So,
okay.
What?
Taking
one.
This one maybe.
So you got all four?
Yeah. Awesome. This one, this one's like 56. No. Based on height. And I think based on height goes here because you know how it's like splitting in half? So it's probably divided by two. So like these go here and then try to like find an equation for this one.
How are you doing?
I think we're kind of like confused because we can't find an equation for this one.
Okay.
It's like,
so what have we matched so far? Let's look at, so we've got this one. Do you feel confident with this one here?
Yeah.
Okay, so this one, area is base times height divided by two. Yes. Do we feel like we know the formula for this one? If we kind of like eliminate them a little, maybe we could figure it out. So what shape is this?
Parallelogram.
Parallelogram. And how do I find the area of a parallelogram?
Divide by two?
Divide what by two?
Do you want me to turn the timer off?
So there's 6 and 8. No,
we actually use different formulas for triangles and parallelograms. So the triangle we're dividing by 2 because that's like it's half of a rectangle and we know that's length times width. With our parallelogram, we're actually not going to divide it by 2. Because if we kind of cut this shape here, if we cut this part off and moved it over here, that's going to make a rectangle. So we actually only need to multiply the base times the height for this one. So do we have a formula that says area is base times height? Look at all your formulas.
This one.
Okay, cool. So if this is the formula that matches this one, and then if we look at what's the base and what's the height for that one?
6 and 8.
Good. And so do we have an answer that's 6 times 8?
Well, I think the question is complicated.
Cool.
So we know that A, B, C.
Oh, I think
what? A.
This one.
I'm guessing.
What's
A equals area equals length times width.
I'm gonna give you guys a little clip.
And then
I want you to look up at the anchor chart over there. Both of you go stand up, go check that out, and then come back and see if that helps a little bit. Okay?
I think the first thing in making sure students are prepared for this type of work is making sure that they have the background information to get started. So for example, on today's task, I made sure that I had an anchor chart of the area formulas because I knew that could be a sticking point for some students. So just thinking about where there are places to scaffold if students need it and leaving it open, but then being able to give support and narrow down if you need to.
All right, my friends, let's all look up here. So we're gonna talk about our answers here. And this is gonna be really helpful today as we do our whiteboard task, knowing these formulas. We've got an anchor chart today that if you get stuck while you're working on your whiteboard task or on this, we could always take a look at our formulas and there's some examples there and always ask if we have questions. So take a look at yours and let's look back up here. So you are going to be working at the whiteboards today and you're going to be working on a task where you are finding the area of composite shapes, just like you did in that last problem in the warm-up, where we're gonna think about how can we break apart a shape into multiple different shapes and find the total area. So we're gonna be working on the task. There are four problems you're gonna work on. You're gonna be working on groups of three.
There's randomized grouping. So students are just working with whoever in the class. It's not pick a group, it's not me assign a group. It's here's a card, go to the group. It's always gonna be different, it's always gonna be fun. They're sharing their thoughts and then they're sharing the marker. So everyone's got a turn.
As you're working, talk about why are you doing what you're doing. Follow along, and if you're not sure, make sure to check in with them, okay? And take turns with that marker.
Everything, really.
What do we all think? Do we agree there?
Yeah.
Yeah, all right. Now, why are we multiplying them?
Get that area.
Okay, cool. So we have a rectangle.
Add together.
Rectangle. So area of one. Okay, cool.
Area together.
Chat together. You got it.
Okay. Alex, can you guys just talk me through your strategy for that first one? What did we do there?
We found the area of this rectangle.
Mm-hmm.
And then we found the area of this rectangle.
Can you go back to the question one more time? Read that second sentence.
Oh.
It's okay. I want to hear what's the second sentence say there?
Give me 16.
Out loud to the whole group because some people over here might not see.
Charge that costs you 2.60 per square foot.
Okay, so there's a second part to the question. This part that you guys did so far looks great. Do you want to pause for 1 minute just to make sure everyone's on the same page? What are we missing? What step did we miss here?
Doing the cost of the charge.
Okay, cool. So we found the area. That looks great. Now let's find the cost. How would we do that?
2.60 times 30.
Okay, so the area that we found times $2.60. Do we all agree there?
Yeah.
Awesome. So as we go through these problems, they're all going to have those two steps, area and then the cost. Awesome. Remember, as we work, make sure we're sharing that marker. Make sure everyone has a turn.
$7, $8.
Three times eight. 24. So here's 24. And then here's 24.
I love that, yeah. Keep going.
And then we could, like, here is like, 5. No, so we can, like, do 3 times 6 here. 3 times 6 is...
18.
And then we can add these together.
23.
Close the triangle.
23 or 23?
22.
So first we do 8 plus 4, which is 12. Then you do 20 plus 10, which is 30. So 30 plus 12, 2. So then we have to figure out this is how to. We can figure this out by doing 3, which it matches up to here. Here's 3, and here's also 3, so we can do 3 times 3. And you get 9. So here is a total. And we do 9. Divided by 2, so you can get, like, because it's a slanted line. 9 divided by 2 is... 4.5?
Yeah, that's awesome. I love that reasoning, and I love that you were following along labeling. That was really good group work. So maybe just put those steps out and then add it together. I want to say one more thing, too, as we work. There is a second part to these tasks. So you want to find the area, but then there's also something about finding the cost. So make sure that we're thinking about both of those. Okay. Awesome. Keep working.
So that means you have to do 4.5, this and picture. Okay. So, like I said,
I want to talk about a couple observations that I'm seeing as we're working.
The first thing I want to notice, I like that I'm seeing a lot of work on those whiteboards. We're organizing our thinking. We're showing all of our steps. That's great. So we can keep track of all this. There's a bunch of steps to these tasks. So keeping it all on that board is awesome. And I like that people labeled like part one, part two, part three. So that's great. One thing that I'm noticing, and I want everyone to go back to your task and look at question one. And read question one all the way through. Everyone take 30 seconds to do that. Go back to question one, read it all the way through. And come back together. What do we notice about that question? What do we notice about that question? Griffin?
6 description.
So there's two parts of the question. First, we're finding the area, and then we're finding the cost. And so, Griffin, multiplication sounds like that could be a really good strategy. So as you're working, make sure that you're reading the question all the way through so that we're answering both parts of the question. I love the work. Keep going. Make sure that we're sharing the marker. If someone hasn't had the marker yet, maybe we pass it on. We've got about 6 more minutes that we're going to keep working.
I have a question here. So it looks like we use the same formula for all 3 shapes. Are all 3 of those shapes the same? So is one of these formulas different than the other? Looks like we just did base times height for all 3. Is there one of those shapes that should use a different formula? Talk to your group first before we fix it. What are you thinking, Nathan?
We gotta do 3 times 3, but we also gotta divide 9 right after.
By what? What do we have to divide by?
By 2.
Why do we have to divide by 2?
Because it's, triangles. It's, to get the area of triangle, it's, base times 8, divided by 2.
Awesome. So because this was a triangle, we got the 9, we have to now divide that by 2. I love that you fixed that. Awesome. So let's fix that, and then we can find the total area, and then do the cost. Nice work.
Again, love the collaboration, love working together. Love that when I look around the room, everyone look around the room for a minute and look at all the math that we did as we solved those problems. What I notice is some people just did algorithms, whereas some people drew pictures, right? So different strategies work for different people, and I love seeing that as we worked. You're gonna look at your work, we're gonna come together. If we find mistakes, that's the best part of this debrief. That's my favorite part because we're learning from each other. So you all had your strategies, you all worked through, and now we're gonna come together and see what we got. And then if we find mistakes, great, we learn from those mistakes. So I want everyone's attention as we talk through this. I wanna hear a lot of different thinking. We're probably gonna stay together for 5 minutes and then you're gonna go back and do some independent work, okay? So can we look at number one? Kevin designed the following golf course. He needs to buy turf to cover the total area. What is the cost of the turf? If it's $2.60 per square feet. Can someone talk me through how did we decompose this mini golf course and how did we find the total area?
One of the things that I really like about the debriefing portion of class is that everyone can learn from their mistakes. And I think that's a huge part of math is being able to understand what mistakes you're making so that you can make a plan in the future, right? And know yourself as a mathematician. And if I'm making calculation mistakes, maybe in the future I need to slow down.
You created your own mini golf course. And our task today is to use what we just practiced of breaking down, decomposing our shape, and then finding the area, and then finding the cost. So we're going to apply this to our project today. Before we do, I want a little check-in to see how do we feel about this independently. So in a minute, when I say go, we're going to clean up our whiteboard spots. We're going to head back to our seat. And individually, you're going to work on this exit ticket, where we now again have to decompose these shapes, decompose this golf course into several shapes. We do have our anchor chart if you need a reminder of any of the formulas. And then you're also gonna find the cost. At the end, ask me any questions, comments, concerns that you have. All right, in a couple of minutes, we're going to hand in what we've got so far. This is helpful to see what parts we feel strong about, what parts are tricky, what we still need to cover this summer. So let's finish that up. I'm going to collect that, and then we'll take a few minutes to look back at our projects.
I think when looking at this task, everything that we did in that lesson, from the warm-up to the whiteboard task to the exit ticket, was to try to get to the point where they could apply it to their own work. And so I think all of those pieces of the lesson, the goal is that all of that practice gets you to the point where you can look at your own creation that you made, you designed this, and you could apply that idea to your own work. The warm-up was kind of leading you there, where it's, here's the formulas, if you're not sure, here's a good reminder. And then we're building on that with, let's work together on this task where you're able to talk together and collaborate and make mistakes and fix the mistakes. And then we're practicing it on our own with that exit ticket. And then the goal is like, let's apply it. Let's make this real world. Let's see your work. And so I think if they could apply what we did in the lesson to their task, I think that's the goal of the project for me.